Let's now learn how to find the surface area of a cylinder. Look at this cylinder with height h and radius r. The top and bottom surfaces are flat circular faces with radius r. Let's keep these aside. What we are now left with is the curved surface, right? The remaining portion of the cylinder is now the lateral or the curved surface. If you look at this length, this is nothing but the perimeter of a circle, right? So this length is 2 pi r. Let me now cut the cylinder here and open it up. What do you see? We have a rectangle, right? We have a rectangle here. This face is nothing but 2 pi r that we saw earlier, the perimeter of the circle, and this other side is nothing but h, right? So what we are left with is a rectangle with length as 2 pi r and breadth as h. The area of this rectangle will be 2 pi r h. That is nothing but your curved surface area, right? So we have two flat surfaces and one curved surface. There's another way to visualize this curved surface. Let's take a rectangle with width r and height h, okay? Now take this as the axis and rotate the rectangle about this axis. What do you see? Looks like a cylinder, right? Looks exactly like a cylinder. Now, if you assume this rectangle to have a thickness 1, we need 2 pi r such rectangles to form the cylinder, right? You need 2 pi r such rectangles. The area of this face is nothing but h, and there are 2 pi r such rectangles that have been placed around, right? So the total area will be h into 2 pi r. 2 pi r h, exactly the same as what we got before. Exactly the same, right? This is just another way to visualize it. So now we know the area of the flat surfaces. We also know the area of the curved surface. You add the two and you'll get the total surface area, right? So what will total surface area be? Two of these circles with area pi r square each, that is 2 pi r square. One curved surface with area 2 pi r h, right? Add these up, you'll get 2 pi r into r plus h, right? That is what a cylinder is all about. Once you visualize the area in this way, you don't really have to memorize any of these formulae, right? Once you've understood what exactly a cylinder is, you'll easily be able to write the formula yourself, right? So that's what a cylinder is all about.
To keep learning with such engaging videos, download BYJU'S, the learning app, today.